We humans have probably been naming and classifying living things in our environment since we were first able to communicate. Whether a plant or animal was dangerous or delicious would have been important information for our earliest ancestors. Modern biological classification got a boost from the 18th century botanist Carl Linnaeus. Linnaeus was the first to group living things according to shared physical characteristics. Grouping like things together still makes scientists' jobs easier. It helps organize the study of the 8 million different species that share our planet. Modern classification begins with categories. These categories are like boxes that scientists put related species into. The categories are ranked from the most general grouping, called domain, to the most specific, called species. A handy way to remember these categories is with this acronym: Dear King Philip, come over for great spaghetti. Every living thing on Earth can be classified by these 8 categories. Let's classify this marine favorite. There are 3 domains of living things, and all plants and animals belong in one of them. The domains of archaea and bacteria contain single-celled microorganisms that have no cell nucleus. The seagoing creature we're classifying belongs to the multi-cell domain, Eukarya. The next category is called kingdom. The kingdoms include plants, animals, fungi, and more. Obviously, this playful creature has the physical characteristics of an animal, so its kingdom is Animalia. Next comes phylum, the body type category. There are about 36 phyla. This animal is grouped with other animals that have backbones in the category called chordata. It's not cold-blooded like fish and reptiles, and it doesn't lay eggs like birds. It belongs with animals that are warm-blooded and produce milk. That's the mammalia, or mammal class. Next comes order. There are dozens of orders, but only one that contains whales and porpoises, which share many characteristics with this animal. They're all members of the cetacean order. Now for its family, it's Delphinidae, or dolphins. But there are many kinds of dolphins. This one is in the genus called Tursiops. At this point, we've narrowed down this animal's classification from all the living things in the world to a genus that has just 3 species in it. The last classification is species. Each species has a unique name. In this case, it's Truncatus. The scientific name for any creature is a combination of its genus and its species. This one is Tursiops truncatus, but you know it as the bottlenose dolphin. Classification helps scientists tell nature some 8 million species apart. It helps determine which have healthy populations and which are at risk. Giving names to the living things around us probably started as a way to help ourselves to nature's bounty. Now, scientific classification has become an important tool for helping understand and protect the natural world.